U.S. Senate now has confirmed John Brennan to be the next CIA director. The final vote, 63 in favor, 34 opposed. Brennan is a former White House counterterrorism advisor, a former CIA deputy director, certainly a top architect of the Obama administration's drone program as well. He will replace the retired U.S. General David Petraeus, who resigned in November amid revelations of an extramarital affair. The Brennan vote follows an almost 13-hour filibuster by Senator Rand Paul. The Tea Party-backed Kentucky Republican blocked the vote while demanding an answer about those drone strikes, potential drone strikes, on American citizens on U.S. soil. That answer came in a letter from the Attorney General just a little while ago, Eric Holder, writing to Senator Paul. While Senator Paul was talking to our own chief congressional correspondent, Dana Bash, he got to read the letter.
It's literally three sentences long, and he says that the answer to your question about can Americans be killed on U.S. soil, and the answer is no. Are you satisfied?
I'm quite happy with the answer, and I'm disappointed it took a month and a half and a root canal to get it, but we did get the answer, and that's what I've been asking all along, and it really is what the Senate should be about, advise and consent and find out what policies are. I have a feeling, since this was so difficult, that I never would have gotten this with routine letters to the White House.
All right, let's bring back Senator Wyden. He was the only Democrat to join Senator Paul's filibuster of John Brennan. Quick question, Senator, are you satisfied with the letter, the explanation from the Attorney General, these three sentences?
I think it is helpful, Wolf, and what he said is really consistent with what I went into on the floor of the Senate yesterday. In effect, the Holder letter now makes it clear if you're talking about a non-combatant in the United States, you cannot use lethal force, you cannot strike with a drone. What the earlier letter said, and it was what I went into yesterday, is that if you're talking about our country having to repel a foreign power, such as in the instance of 9/11 or something of that nature, you can use a military force. So we're continuing to root out more of the details about our policies. And I can tell you, Wolf, that this debate about drones, both in Washington, D.C. and in our country, is just beginning. There is a lot more work to be done. And I think you're going to see Democrats and Republicans here in the United States Senate, we kind of call ourselves the Checks and Balances Caucus, spending a lot of time trying to bring to light, consistent with national security, more details about the drone program.